get everything lined up just so. Last year, I don't know if last year was the first year I tried pumpkin beers, but I did a comparison, a head-to-head between two pumpkin beers and a pumpkin cider, and there was a winner and a loser. Well, I brought the winner back because I like good beer. Today we'll be drinking and enjoying Hopworks Brewery's Great Gourds of Fire, a pumpkin ale with ancho chilies and spices. Actually, set it up there, not down there. Let it get its moment in the light. Well, that's quite the effusive head. Good smells. The things I remember liking about this beer last year was that, especially in comparison to the other beer I tried, which shall not be named, you can look it up. It was just a year ago. This beer seemed to have a more consistent body. It was connected beginning to end. There wasn't anything missing in the middle. I didn't have to wait for it to warm up. It was good cold. It was good, room temperature. I don't think I've reviewed it room temperature, but you know, as it comes up to temperature in my glass, I still like it. Yeah, there's some more nuance and some additional depth in it, but it's just ready to go out of the fridge, out of the can, into the glass, into my mouth. And also the flavors were pleasant. Particularly in comparison to that other beer I tried, I think I was able to detect the fact that they had clearly roasted the pumpkins for this beer. What I don't recall is that it was a pumpkin ale with ancho chilies and spices. That would seem to indicate there should be some spiciness to it. We'll get to that. But just for now, I was super happy after I did the Rogue pumpkin ale that I did a few weeks ago. I think that review is up or should be up. Yeah, I think it's up. It was a decent beer. It wasn't offensive, but it did still feel as though it had kind of that hole in the middle. And I think that warming that beer up improves it. It has a nice earthy start, and then it kind of has this empty middle, and then the spices come on later, as I recall. But let's try not to do too many comparisons and just appreciate this for what it is. A good beer. Smell-wise, this smells like a kitchen in which you're making pumpkin pie and warming apple cider. And that's a really good smell to have. So there's definitely the pumpkin spices, the pumpkin pie spices, the cinnamon, the clove, the nutmeg, the allspice, that sort of thing. Maybe a bit of a brown sugar, but there's also definitely an apple character to it. That's really nice. The head goes away pretty quickly. The head is decently cream colored. I believe that the other pumpkin ale I tried, Rogue's pumpkin ale, was quite cream colored too. This one maybe not quite so much. And it's certainly willing to come back too. Yeah, that's a good beer. That's a very nice beer. No missing middle. I don't know what they do. I don't know how it's done. I don't know where the missing middle comes from, where that kind of empty spot comes from in the way that the beer flavor proceeds from start to finish, but this beer just doesn't have it. You open with stewed pumpkin. That's great. That's what you want. Kind of earthy. It kind of tastes of fall. Really nice. After that, the spices start to come and some sweetness. An apple cider-like sweetness. Sorry, I keep going back and forward. I don't know if that's going to mess with focus on my camera. I recall moving leaves behind me previously when the sun was back, a lot of them caused focus issues. There's no sun on these leaves, so I don't know. We'll see. But I'll try not to do a whole lot of back and forth because I know that is likely to mess with the camera. Anyways, back to the beer. Earthy, mild, fall, roasty pumpkin, roasted gourd, roasted squash, like deeply roasted. And then this kind of subtle building spice. There's not quite so much of the pumpkin spice in this beer as there was in the Rogue, which is just fine. If pumpkin pie spice isn't your pumpkin spice isn't your thing, that's fine. This is a pumpkin beer, not necessarily a pumpkin spice beer. While it does smell a lot of the pumpkin spices, the flavors are a little more muted. There might be some cinnamon, but I'm not really getting any of the clove or the nutmeg or the allspice in the flavor. And then you have this really subtle, nice apple that kind of comes through, apple juice that kind of comes through towards the end and rounds it out. And I might be able to tell myself that there's a wee hint of warmth down my throat, which I think might be the chili. But I'm not really tasting a chili, ancho chili flavor per se. Yeah, I'm guessing it's probably just part of the whole body of flavor that are going into this. It's integrated and unified. It's helping build the body and the overall flavor character of the beer rather than standing out on its own and being a standalone flavor note. At least that's how I'm going to interpret it, because I'm inclined to interpret it generously. You know, it's what you do when you enjoy beer, right? You apologize for its faults. There's probably a lesson there, or at least an observation about things we like. We can apologize for its faults, and sometimes they're innocuous and meaningless, like whether I can taste the ancho chili that the can, that a beer can label contains, or sometimes it can be less innocuous and it can actually be a problem. But that's something for us to suss out ourselves, I think, or in concert with good friends over good beer, which is what this is. Definitely good beer, like it. It stands up. It remains my favorite pumpkin beer, and that is Hopworks Brewery's Great Gourds of Fire Pumpkin Ale with ancho chilies and spices, made with Bella organic pumpkins. Anyways, this is me, Matthew. I've been chewing the brew, and I'll catch y'all on the flip side.